Now let us discuss about reflexive relation and irreflexive relation. First let us see about reflexive relation. A relation R on a set X is reflexive if X comma X belongs to R for any X belongs to X. Here R is nothing but relation on a set X. Set is always represented with the help of uppercase letter, whereas the members of the set, the elements of the set are represented by using lowercase letters. Okay, let we have a set like this. So X is equal to X comma Y comma Z. Okay, so set is represented always with uppercase letters, whereas the members may be either numbers or it may be some symbols, or if we have alphabets, then the elements of the set, the members of the set must be lowercase letters only. Okay, here capital X means name of the set, small x means element of the set. Okay, a relation R on a set X is reflexive if X comma X belongs to R. That means here what is small x? Element. So the element present in the set is belonging to R. For any X belongs to X, here this X, small x is nothing but element of the set, whereas capital X is nothing but that set name. So let us take an example for that. So let we have a set called capital X where the elements are 1 comma 2 comma 3. So here this 1 2 3 are nothing but elements of the set. So when we can say that it is reflexive relation if X comma X belongs to R. So what is X comma X? Here what are the members of the set? 1 2 3. So if 1 comma 1 belongs to R, 2 comma 2 belongs to R, and 3 comma 3 belongs to R, then we can say that it is reflexive relation. Okay, so for that let us take an example. Let we have a relation called R. So R is equal to, let the relation contains several ordered pairs such as 1 comma 1, 1 comma 2, 2 comma 1 comma 3, next to 2 comma 1, next to 2 comma 2, next to pair is like this, let it be 3 1, next to pair is 3 3. Okay, now we have to check whether this relation is reflexive relation or not. So when we can say that it is reflexive relation if X comma X belongs to R. Here what are the elements of the set? 1 2 3. So if 1 1 and what is the another element? 2 2 and what is the another element? 3 3. If 1 1 ordered pair, 2 2 ordered pair, 3 3 ordered pair present in the relation, then we can say that it is reflexive relation. So if you observe the relation, here we have 1 comma 1, here we have 2 comma 2, here we have 3 comma 3. So that means, so 1 comma 1 is belonging to R, 2 comma 2 belongs to R, as well as 3 comma 3 belongs to R. So we can say that, that means these three pairs are available in the relation. Then we can say that it is reflexive relation, reflexive relation. So now let us eliminate one pair. Let us eliminate 2 comma 2. Now let's check whether it is reflexive relation or not. It is not reflexive relation. Why? Because reflexive relation means here what are the elements of the set? 1 comma 2 comma 3. But 2 comma 2 is not present in the relation. So if 2 comma 2 is not present in the relation, then we can say that it is not a reflexive relation. Okay. Let us assume that we have 2 comma 2. Here in addition to 1 comma 1, 2 comma 2, 3 comma 3, we may have several other ordered pairs. We should not bother about that. So here we have 1 comma 2, 1 comma 3, 2 comma 1, 3 comma 1 also present in the relation. But we should not bother about that. We have to focus only on whether X comma X is present in the relation or not. Okay. Let us assume that X means some ABC. 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 Then if A comma A, B comma B, C comma C present in the relation, then we can say that it is reflexive relation. Suppose if one pair or all the pairs are missing, then we can say that is not reflexive relation. Okay, so this is about reflexive relation. Now let us see the second one. What is irreflexive relation? A relation R on a set X is irreflexive if X comma X doesn't belongs to R for any X belongs to X. Okay. Let the set is represented by capital A, let the elements of the set are like this. So A comma B comma C. So let we have a relation like this. So R is equal to 1 comma 1, 1 comma 2, 3 comma 2, next to 2 comma 3, next to 3 comma 3. Now let us check whether it is reflexive relation or not. So what is reflexive relation? If x comma x doesn't belongs to R, then we can say that it is irreflexive relation. Here what is x? The small x is nothing but elements of the set, members of the set. That means A comma B comma, let here the elements are like this, 1, 2, 3 only. So that means 1, 1 as well as 2, 2 and 3, 3 should not present in the relation. Should not present in the relation. If one pair or two pairs or all the pairs are present in the relation, then we can say that it is not irreflexive relation. If we observe here, there is no problem for 1, 2. There is no problem for 3, 2. There is no problem for 2, 3. But if we observe the pairs 1, 1 as well as 3, 3. So here 1, 1 is present in the relation. 1, 1 belongs to R as well as 3, 3 belongs to R. So we can say that it is not irreflexive relation. What is irreflexive relation? Those pairs should not present in the relation. 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3 pairs should not present in the relation. But here 1 comma 1 as well as 3 comma 3 present in the relation. So that's why we can say that this is not irreflexive relation. Now let us modify this diagram. So let we have pairs like this 1 comma 2. Next let us remove this. Now let's check whether it is reflexive or not. So here we have 1 comma 2. There is no problem. Here we have 3 comma 2. There is no problem. Here we have 2 comma 3. There is no problem. So we can say that it is reflexive relation. So why we can call this relation as irreflexive relation? Why? Because x comma x, that means 1 comma 1 doesn't present in the relation, 2 comma 2 doesn't present in the relation, 3 comma 3 doesn't present in the relation. So that's why we can say that this is irreflexive relation. So it is very, very easy to remember this one. Okay. So if x comma x belongs to R, then it is called as reflexive relation, whereas if x comma x doesn't belongs to R, then we can say that it is irreflexive relation.